Someone like Dave Dobbyn hardly requires a big introduction. We got together to hear his thoughts about his latest album, Twist.
Well, Twist, to me, is it's an album, it's a document of returning to New Zealand. It's you know, there's a cathartic thing that happened through all that, and I was sort of finding my way through it, so Twist was the result of that, of being inspired by the light and the landscape of this town, you know, Auckland in particular. But just a whole feel of, you know, rediscovering some nooks and crannies that I never valued before, and then reflecting that in the music, and that seemed to come through.
Protection, it could be a friend to blame. Protection, someone invented it. Possession, maybe was where we started. Protection, ain't no eternal flame.
I tried a couple of really angsty songs out, one being a song about my mother, which didn't make it. And it was a jazz song, so the rhythm section was frowning somewhat through the whole process, so I tossed that away and tuned the guitar to an open tuning and played Protection down. It was pretty much like what the demo I did out at the beach. I'd made a demo of it, and Protection, I wanted to sing this song where, you know, it's like a little note really, saying, you know, I can protect you from everything but not me.
If you can then I know you will. If you can then push you a little further. If you can, you know I'll shelter you. If you can, I'll take everything.
Oh, Naked Flame, that was along with a bit of a partner to Protection in a way, in that it's quite intimate and it had to be as sensual as possible, you know, because it has to do with sex and, you know, marriage and a house and domestics and the whole finding stuff within that that's got a bit of poetic grunt. That song went through quite a few changes. It sort of did it almost a full circle. We tried it out. Neil tried to get me to try it out kind of rockabilly. And it sort of worked, but it didn't quite get there. So once we were frustrated at going through all these takes trying to get it in this rockabilly feel, we just turned around and I just said, let's just play it, you know. And so we played it and it sounded like right, you know, it sounded perfect, so it found its own ground at the right time, you know, almost at the point where we were about to abandon it and move on to something else. So Tom Waits has a saying for the songs that work like that, they're quite hard to work out, and there's always one or two of them on an album, and they're worth putting the work into because they're like a red-headed stepchild. So you've always got to sort of whack it over the head a while and it'll come around.
Rain.
And I think musically there's a lot of humour in, you know, in terms of some of the motifs being played on the whole album. There's a few things that are kind of really jarring to some ears. You know, there's a solo on a song called Lap of the Gods, which is played on this incredibly horrible instrument. It was a guitar that had a wire connected to this little old box. It was like an organ box, and it was a Hammond guitar, you know, from about the, you know, mid-60s or something, and it made these horrible noises, and so we knew that we could get something out of that, you know. The trails are toughy for me because it's a couple of friends and acquaintances have come up to me since and said, is that song about me? I said, well, you can think what you like. It's about the process of betrayal. I think somewhere along the way you need to be betrayed or betray somebody else. It can be the same feeling, whether you're being betrayed or you are betraying somebody. It can be exactly the same feeling. And you have to do that in some way to get a kind of, as Neil put it, a sort of a rites of passage song, you know, pushing away the dirt and just saying, telling it like it is.
Thought I was lazy, you held the franchise beyond disappointment. My fate is shredded.
Ah, What Do You Really Want? This is the song that was a little bit of a, there's another saying that Tom Waits has, that when you're playing along a song, he'd say, he'd interrupt the songs and go, "No, sounds like the kids are out on the bonnet. You should bring him in the car with the rest of us." You know, and that was similar to the Red-Headed Reptile thing, you know, a song that takes a while to strangle and get a hold on. That song started out as a piano ballad.
What do you
A lot of atmosphere on the album. It's mainly atmosphere, actually, which came about through that process—a really organic process of just describing things, really, just describing things through the songs, describing the depth of experience, I guess, or a new experience of the place. So that was what we wanted to do, and that's what we did, and more. So. You know, it's one I'll never get sick of.
After the break, Dave's language and Shehad's bitter.